I have a special affinity with the Granite series of large language models from IBM, and it's probably not what you think. Now, yes, this is the family of LLMs from my employer, so I should probably be saying nice things, but what endeared me most of all to a particular Granite model called Granite 13b.v2, which is a 13 billion parameter model released in 2024, was that it was completely transparent about its training data, and that training data contained, well, a lot of my stuff. Like, for example, it included all US patents from the USPTO dating back to 1975, and a few hundred of those patents were mine. And it was trained also on IBM docs, including Red Books. And writing and leading Red Books had been my day job for over a decade. And actually, do you know who led the project for the longest ever Red Book? That was me. Look, here it is here. This guy is nearly 2,000 pages long. We had to find a specialized printing company just to bind it. Anyways, the point is, I felt seen by Granite. Well, now IBM has released the next generation of Granite models. So the new set of models are Granite 4.0. And these models, they deliver higher performance, faster speeds, and significantly lower operational costs compared to similar models, including previous Granite models, but also compared to much larger models as well. And this being a tech channel, I wanted to get into some pretty interesting details about the architecture of these models, specifically the combination of transformers and Mamba 2. But first, let's briefly talk about what this Granite 4.0 family of small models look like. Now, there are currently several models in the family. First one we'll talk about is called Small. It's kind of the workhorse. It's designed for enterprise tasks like running multi-tool agents or handling complex workflows on a single enterprise GPU. Now, this is a mixture of experts model, and it comes with 32 billion total parameters, of which there are 9 billion active parameters. And I'll get into what an active parameter is in just a sec. So that's Small. Then there is the Tiny model. Now, Tiny is built for low latency, for local and edge use cases. And like Small, it's another mixture of experts model. It has 7 billion total parameters and 1 billion active parameters. And then there are a couple of micro models as well. And like Tiny, they're intended for lightweight local deployments, but they use a dense architecture with 3 billion parameters. Now, one uses the same hybrid architecture as Tiny and Small, and the other micro model that uses a traditional transformer model. But the theme here are models that are small in size with fast inference that don't need much in the way of compute to run. And I really want to focus in on the memory efficiency for a moment, because this is really where the Granite 4.0 models really stand out. So in a production workload, if you think about long context and multi-batch tasks, the micro model, that only requires about 10 GB of GPU memory to actually run. While comparable models, they'll typically need four times that amount or maybe six times that amount. And then Tiny and Small, they share the same kind of advantage as well. So the result is that Granite 4.0's hybrid design can reduce memory requirements up to 80%, all while delivering higher performance across many tasks and running at faster speeds. And then speaking of speeds, I would say that is another advantage. Most models, they kind of tend to slow down as you increase batch size or context length, but Granite 4.0's design actually keeps throughput high while other models hit their limits. And then also, if we think about performance, there are some advantages there as well. Granite 4.0 models are competitive within their model weight classes, but they're also competitive over much larger models as well, especially on benchmarks that measure performance on key agentic tasks. The small model, for example, outperforms nearly every open model on instruction following benchmarks and keeps pace even with frontier models on function calling. So kind of this balance of speed and efficiency and accuracy is exactly why the architecture behind Granite 4.0 is so interesting. So let's get into the details of that architecture. And first of all, let's talk about Mamba. Now, the dominant architecture of AI isn't really Mamba, of course. It is the transformer architecture. And transformer-based models, well, they've been around for a good while. But in 2023, researchers from Carnegie Mellon and Princeton introduced a new architecture called Mamba, and it is a type of state space model, or an SSM. And SSMs, they're a bit like recurrent neural networks that dominated natural language processing tasks before transformers came along. And Mamba solves the limitations that really kind of made us abandon RNNs in the first place. And now we have Mamba 2 that is an optimized implementation of this Mamba architecture. But so what? Well, look, while transformers use self-attention to process text, which is incredibly powerful, but also computationally expensive, Mamba maintains what's essentially a summary of previous context. It processes each new token. It selectively decides what's important enough to update that summary with. Now, this means that Mamba's computational needs scale in a linear fashion with the context length, while transformers, they scale in a quadratic relationship with the context length. So let me put that in practical terms. If you double your context window with a transformer model, your computational requirements, they 4x, they quadruple. With Mamba, they nearly double. And that's a huge efficiency gain, especially when we're talking about handling ever larger LLM context windows. But here's the thing. Transformers, they still have some advantages. They're better at certain tasks like in-context learning and complex reasoning. So how does this all relate to the Granite 4.0 family? Well, the Granite 4.0 architecture is a hybrid architecture. It uses 9 Mamba blocks for every 1 transformer block. Mamba kind of does the heavy lifting of capturing global context, then it lets the transformer blocks work their magic on parsing the nuanced local details, the efficiency of Mamba with the precision of transformers. Now, the second part of this hybrid approach is mixture of experts, or MoE. And MoE is used for the tiny and the small models. And this is where the active parameters I mentioned earlier comes in. So MoE divides the model into different experts. These are specialized neural subnetworks, and it uses a routing mechanism to activate only the specific experts that it needs for a particular task. And the Granite 4.0 models are what we call fine-grained MoE models. So tiny, if you remember tiny, I said that the tiny model has 7 billion total parameters, and then it has 1 billion active parameters. And that means active at inference time. Well, that model, tiny, it has 62 different experts, but for any given token, it only activates the specific expert that it needs, plus there's a shared expert that's always active. It's pretty efficient. And similarly with the small model that has 32 billion total parameters, 9 billion active parameters, it uses a similar routing strategy. And one last architectural note. Most models use some form of positional encoding, like rope, that's rotary positional encoding, to help the model understand word order. But these encoding schemes, they often struggle with sequences longer than what they saw during training. Well, Granite says nope to rope, quite literally, because nope is no positional encoding, which so far has had no adverse effects on LON context performance, which means without the computational overhead of positional encoding and with Mamba's linear scaling properties, the Granite 4.0 model architecture is designed to theoretically have an unconstrained context length, meaning you can send in as many tokens as your hardware and memory supports. So look, we are really seeing two emerging paths with AI model development. We've got bigger and bigger models with more parameters and longer reinforcement learning cycles from model providers that are chasing AGI. And then we've, on the other hand, we've kind of got the spectrum of smaller models that really push the limits of what small models can do, and that they can run on a GPU that you can buy online for, let's say, a couple of $100, which is pretty cool. Now, Granite 4.0 models are open source, so check them out on Hugging Face or whatsthenext.ai if you'd like to see exactly what small language models are capable of doing.